Hi, this is John Bjork, PC Mag. We're here at ASRock's booth at Computex 2024 at the mighty wall of motherboards. There's Intel ARC video cards actually over there, followed by AMD and Intel next generation boards. Let's take a look. We've got the ARC A770 Phantom Gaming, 16 gigs, followed by below that, the Challenger model. And then we've got the two lower end cards here, the A750 and A580, both of which are mid-range. And then at the very bottom is Intel's ARC A380 low profile. You don't see too many low-profile cards these days, especially for half-height cases. They're just not as much a thing as they used to be. But ASRock is one of the few vendors with a relatively recent GPU that is true half-height. Here we have ASRock's lineup of Ryzen 9000 motherboards. They're on the AM5 socket, and they're on the X870E or X870 chipset. We can see up top the usual flagship Tai Chi model. It's got some nice heavy stuff over the VRMs and M2 slots. Below it is the Tai Chi Lite with a sort of lighter looking actually design, and then the usual Nova Riptide Steel Legend and Pro RS models. One thing to notice about these X870 and X870E boards is that all of them actually have support for PCI Express 5 SSDs. In ASRock's case, they call it Blazing M2, but it's basically ultra high speed M2 SSD compatibility. Previously, you would see PCI Express 5 M2 slots only on the high end boards in a line, but here all six boards have it included in at least one slot. So over here we have ASRock's lineup of next generation Intel motherboards. Now they've definitely got the largest selection we've seen at the show so far, and I can't imagine anybody else would have more. Almost a dozen boards up and down the wall over here for Intel Arrow Lake. So there are a lot of boards here. The most interesting is the Tai Chi Aqua. You'll notice, as is typical of the Aqua boards from ASRock, this one's got built-in liquid cooling channels over the VRMs and over some of the other motherboard elements up here around the CPU socket. This is typically in ASRock's line, the high-end board usually runs at least a grand or a little above or below that. One of the features that I'm noticing on most of these boards here is something called Easy Release, which is this little trigger here over the PCI Express main slot for the video card. We're seeing a lot of push-button solutions. This one's a slider, but I've seen that before. That actually looks nice and chunky and easy to get your finger on. Another interesting model here seems to be the Tai Chi OCF Cam 2. We're seeing from various vendors implementations of this new memory form factor, Cam 2. You can implement it as dual-channel memory, but it's flat on the motherboard. We first saw this with a few laptops in the last year or so, and it makes sense in the laptop space in that you're looking for a low-profile, thin memory solution, but we're starting to see it on desktop in a couple of places, which is interesting. We'll see if it actually gets much pickup as time goes on. So we won't go through all dozen of ASRock's Arrow Lake boards on the wall. They look like they parallel most of ASRock's existing lines, but those two that we looked at there look like the special ones in the line for when they come later this year.